Not something you'd expect from North Korean TV. But the country's state broadcaster, Korean Central TV, has been experimenting with a new high-tech look. KCTV's bulletins are known for their plain format and a signature news reading style. But one day in late March, North Korean watchers got a surprise. The economics report of the main news bulletin was presented by a young female newsreader wearing a Western-style suit. But most importantly, the report featured graphics throughout, which is very unusual, as well as drone footage and time-lapse videos. So what's behind this new contemporary look?
Officially, North Korean television doesn't have any competition. People are banned from watching foreign TV channels. There's no cable TV, there's no satellite TV in the country. Most homes, if they get television, only get one channel. But unofficially, there's a lot more competition. A lot of information is flowing in from overseas on USB sticks and on SD memory cards. And a lot of that is Chinese and US and UK and European movies. And then also a lot of South Korean television. North Korean TV has realized that it has to start to innovate, has to make itself look a bit more interesting if it's to hold the attention of people in North Korea.
Normally, it takes KCTV a day or two to report what's going on. But it has recently reported news much faster. One example was Kim Jong-un's recent trip to Vietnam to meet President Donald Trump.
That type of coverage is pretty unprecedented for the channel. And we only assume that the reason is because more and more people are listening to foreign radio broadcasts, that North Korea has to get out there and it has to get its own view of what's going on to the people before the information coming in from overseas gets too widespread.
Another new thing we notice is ordinary people making a rare appearance on state TV. Normally, production is confined to the studio, but during the Kim-Trump summit, the TV cameras went out on the street to sample the mood. Now back to the high-tech stuff. So the look is new, but what about the content?
North Korean TV is a propaganda organization of the state. It tries to tell people how well the country is doing. So in these economic news segments, well, what we usually see is reports on how production at factories is going up, on how companies are producing new goods for consumers. The content hasn't changed very much. It looks a little bit better, but it's almost like, sprinkling some sugar on a very bland meal.
We only saw this as one single news bulletin. The next day, it was back to normal. Are we going to see this again?
What it looks like is maybe that they were trying this out. Maybe there were people outside of central television that wanted to see it or that had to sign off. There is, of course, in North Korea, one very important person who gives feedback on everything, and that is Kim Jong-un. It's possible that this news bulletin was produced for him or for people in the higher levels of the ruling party, and they're now giving their feedback. And North Korean TV is going to be taking that feedback and maybe implementing it in the future, maybe fine-tuning how they're doing things. It's also quite possible that we never see this again, that this was some sort of one-time exercise. The more you look at North Korea, the more these little mysteries come up, and sometimes you see things and you're never quite sure why they happened.